Hey guys, and welcome to today's video. Today I will be showing you just a kind of typical day in life in hotel quarantine in Australia. So I am actually on day 13, so by the time you see this video, I will have gone, I will be out of here. So yeah, just keep that in mind when you watch this. So yeah, I'm on day 13 today. Obviously tomorrow is day 14, but I don't actually get to leave until day 15 because you have to do all of day 14, if you get what I mean. So yeah, today, what's on the agenda? Not much. So basically today I'm hoping for a negative corona test result, because yesterday I got my second corona swab, and yeah, if that is negative, then I get to leave, no worries. And if it's positive, then I have to stay for like another week or something. So that would not be ideal. It is currently 6:30 in the morning, around that. So we get served breakfast between 7 and 8. It can be like at 7 or it can be like 7:30. It's usually around that time. So yeah, I will show you the meal when I get it. Basically what they do is they just knock on that door there and they just leave it outside and I just go out and pick it up. Like, some people didn't realize that I really have to stay in this room. Like, I can't go out that door. So yeah, it's literally just this room, and there's a bathroom just behind that wall. I might give you a little room tour actually. So I'll show you that now. So here I have my bed, obviously very badly made. a little chair and table. Here is where I eat my dinner. See, like, lots of water bottles. We can drink the water out of the taps here, so that's grand. I don't have to buy water. Then we have this table desk thing that I just kind of like write at or whatever. Here I have the bins. I put them out each day for to be collected, so I'll show you what happens there. That's just my suitcase, a wardrobe, this little coffee maker thing. I used it once, but I don't really drink coffee. My other suitcase, which I obviously haven't unpacked because I'm like leaving. Here is the bathroom. The shower has like a really funny smell of I don't know, like egg or something from the drain, which isn't nice, but the rest of the bathroom is super nice. Oh my god, I'm so stupid. When I arrived, this was plugged down and I could not figure out how to unplug it, and I literally called up reception to ask them. They must have thought I was so stupid, but anyway, you just press it. But yeah, it's a really nice room. Like, it's not like I need a lot of space to be like running around. I do like my workouts there, and there's kind of enough room there. So yeah, it's pretty sweet. Also, just to say, if you're wondering why I'm in Australia and why I have an Irish accent and if I'm even Australian, watch my last video. It's called I'm Moving to Australia, and it explains why I'm going. And I also have like a whole vlog of my trip, because boy, it was a long one. and it was a little bit eventful. So yeah, if you want to watch them, I have them up as well. Is this channel going to turn into a travel vlog? I don't know. I know, probably not. I still have some horsey vlogs to upload, and hopefully I'll get to ride some horses when I'm at my final destination.
I actually forgot to tell you guys the one really bad part of this hotel room, and that's the fact that my window doesn't open. It's such a pity. Some of the rooms have balconies. Like, imagine how nice that would be. You could actually go outside. But yeah, I think they're more reserved for people that have like underlying health conditions and stuff, which is obviously way more important for them to have fresh air than me. I'm like completely fine. So yeah, it's a bit of a pity, but people definitely need it more than I do. But yeah, 2 weeks with no fresh air and no like direct sunlight, which is kind of bit rubbish, because I was sitting by the window loads and then I googled it and you actually can't absorb like vitamin D or anything through glass. It's a little bit of a shame. I know like there's a lot of like complaints about this online. If you like search up any like news articles and stuff, lots of people are very, very angry that we don't have open windows. And like, in fairness, it would be so nice if we did. But apparently they just don't have like enough rooms with like opening windows or balconies, so it's just life, I suppose. But yeah, my breakfast should be arriving any minute, so I will see you then. I hear movement outside for my food. There's my knock. It's gone. I'm too scared to poke my head down the hall because there's a security guard like at the end of the hall, so he would have seen me go like, hey. So anyway, here is my breakfast. I'll give you like a breakfast haul. No, I'm kidding. Okay, so for breakfast today we have a croissant, 10 out of 10. Love a good croissant. Got some juice, like a little fruit tub. And then we always get like a hot part too, but like I don't know why, but mine is always cold. But like, to be honest, like croissant, fruit and like juice is kind of enough breakfast for me. I'm literally expending no energy here. This is gonna be like a common theme in the video, guys, so if you don't like the sight of wasted food, you're not gonna like this video. I'm sorry. So anyway, also I'm vegetarian, so also keep that in mind. So this is the breakfast. So we have like halloumi things. I think that's scrambled eggs, wedges and beans, which is really nice. And it's actually warmer than usual. So they must have known that I was videoing today. And then we get like a menu for the rest of the day. So we know what we're gonna get. So yeah, I'm gonna eat this now before it gets super cold. And I'll see you when I'm finished. Okay, so I'm done my breakfast. I put everything in the bag it came in and put it into dinner from last night, and then I put lunch on top of that, and then it gets picked up around 3. So that's my routine for the rubbish. I don't really have any other waste because there's nothing in here. So it's just really the food that I put out. So yeah, I'm gonna just like chill in my bed for a hot minute and digest my food. And then I've started doing yoga in the morning, which is like really random. I've never really done it before, but it was like a good thing to start when I have so much free time. Also, yeah, it's like yoga for flexibility though. Yeah, because I'm so stiff from riding the horses. So I've started doing that. And yeah, I've seen some results. Like I was so bad. Like there's this one thing where you have to like hold your leg like this, and I literally couldn't even hold my leg, and look, now I can like do that, which is like a lot better than it was. So yeah, I'm just gonna like chill for a bit. I've become addicted to TikTok, but I actually resisted making a TikTok. I thought maybe the boredom would get to me so much that I would actually make a TikTok, but no, I can't bring myself to do it. I'm too scared. So yeah, that's what I'm gonna do now for a bit, and then I'll see when I'm doing yoga. I'm gonna apologize in advance for what you're gonna see on that floor. Please don't judge me. I'm not very good at yoga. Okay. Okay, so I am dressed. I'm in kind of leggings and I'm about to do the yoga. Oh, this is funny. I'm just gonna like do like a time lapse of me doing it. I'll show you which one I'm doing. So this is the one I've been doing. It's yoga with Adrian. My mum like does lots and lots of yoga and she uses her videos. So, and look, she's a dog, it's so cute. Anyway, so this is what I'm gonna do. And yeah, I'm gonna go and do it. Thank you. so that's my yoga done. Later on I'll do like a workout as well. I kind of like space it out so I can use up more time, I suppose. Like my whole day is just like orientated around like using up time so that I'm not like doing nothing for too long. Like instead of say doing like all like everything in the morning and then I have the whole day to do nothing, I'd rather like stagger it out. So yeah, so now it's let me check what time it is. So it's now 8:30, so it's still really early. And yeah, lunch is delivered around between 12 and 1, so I have until then to do something with my life. They gave us a Sudoku 2 days ago and I'm still trying to do it. It's so hard. Let me show you. It's not a normal one where it's like 9 numbers per box. It has 16 numbers per box. As you can see, I filled in some of it. Oh my God. But I'm addicted to it. Like, it's so good. So I'm gonna do that for a bit. Then other things that I do are like edit videos for YouTube, but I'm up to date on that now. I'll also do some study for my job, which I'm starting in like 3 days. What else? Watch some YouTube. I can read some books. My good friend Laura gave me a book as a kind of going away gift, which was such a good gift. So I have that to read, and I'm also like halfway through a book that I need to finish before I can read that one. So I have that. That's kind of it. Like, there's not a lot to do. Yeah, I have just been watching a lot of TikTok. There's also like some show jumping live streams on from shows on this weekend and stuff. So I've been watching them and yeah, I'm just trying to keep busy. So for now, I'm gonna do my Sudoku. I've been really like, I've hit a wall with it. I have not got a number in so long. Like there's loads of ones where say like there's only two squares left in a box. And I know, say this one here, like I know one's 13 and one's 14, but I don't know which one's which. Like I have so many of those where it's like, yeah, it could be either number. And I'm kind of stuck and I've hit a little bit of a wall. Last night I was like, okay, one more number and I can go to sleep. And I literally couldn't even get one more number and I had to just give up and it was the worst feeling ever. I know, I'm taking this a bit seriously, but yeah. So hopefully I will get some numbers and finish this goddamn thing. I definitely should have brought a book of Sudoku. I never even thought of it, but in hindsight, like if there's one thing I would have brought that I didn't bring, it would be a book of Sudoku. Like they're really addictive and really fun and very like therapeutic, and hours go by and you don't even realize. So anyway, that's what I'm gonna do now. I also like to have a bit of a playlist going while I am watching it. Also, new artist that I absolutely love, Tash Sultana, and she's actually Australian, so shout out to my friend Billy for recommending her to me. I'm addicted to all her music, so that's what I'll be listening to while I'm doing my Sudoku, looking out onto my view. Another very important part of my day is watching the news. So yeah, to kind of keep updated with what's going on in Victoria, because obviously I'm in South Australia right now, so I need to drive to Melbourne, or not to Melbourne, to Victoria, to Bendigo, where I'm going to be working. And yeah, it's just good to know what all the rules are and everything, and that they're not changing it, the cases are going down, so like that's also a good sign. Yeah, the border's still open for me to travel into Victoria, and I have like a letter from, I will get a letter from the hotel and from the South Australian like health department saying that I'm okay to travel, because I just did quarantine, so I definitely won't have coronavirus. So yeah, it's looking good. Like the cases are going down. There's still a stay at home order, so like it won't affect me too much. I can still drive to work and everything like that. And you're allowed to travel to move house, which I will obviously have to move into a house when I get there, and everything like that. So yeah, I think it's gonna be okay. I doubt they're gonna change anything too drastically in 2 days, and that's when I leave here in 2 days, so fingers crossed all goes well. Alrighty, I had a little nap, don't tell anyone, and now it's time for lunch. Thank you. I just made contact with someone. I just saw the guy. I also forgot to say, all the days blurred to one. I can't even remember if it happened today or not. But a police officer comes to our room once a day, sometimes twice a day, just to make sure we're still in the room. That did happen this morning. I obviously didn't video, I can't like video a police officer. So they just make sure we're still there. And we also get a phone call from the nurse who asks us about if we have any symptoms and everything like that. They're my two like social interactions for the day. And yeah, I suppose it makes sure that I'm still alive also for them. I'm gonna eat my lunch now, show you what's in it. So the vegetarian lunch today is apparently, there's always like a salad, but I'm not very good at eating the salads. Also a vegetable paella, tomato, capsicum, artichoke, mushrooms, green peas, and then hazelnut mousse for dessert. Yeah, we got dessert with lunch and dinner. This is why I need to work out, and also is why I can't eat all of it all the time. I should also probably mention that you're allowed to order food in from like any restaurants or anything like that. There's like Uber Eats and stuff. This isn't really my cup of tea. I'm really worried about coming off badly in this video, but I know I'm kind of a picky eater. But like, I'm totally like, I know I am. Like, I do not blame like the hotel at all. Like, I'm so happy to buy my own food if I don't like something. I only had to like buy lunch once, so that's like pretty good so far. I'm that annoying person who's a picky eater. I'm sorry guys, don't come at me. I'm gonna have the little bread roll. Like in general, the meals have been really nice, and like especially because, where's my fork? Where's my knife? The knife in this? Oh, sorry. Especially because it's like such a diverse group of people here. Like there's people from all different countries. Yeah, so like, and there's also a lot of people from India. They were already here when we arrived, and yeah, there was some like issues with the food, like they weren't very happy. So we had like a lot of curries and stuff, which was, I was delighted, like I like that too. We have like a Facebook group that we're all part of, well you can join it if you want. And yeah, like they put in the menu, they put in like, there's like a daily quiz, which I haven't done yet, but I'm not good at quizzes, so I was like, eh. what else do they do? And like people like put in like if they're having any issues and stuff, and there was this one guy and he was like not happy chappy. He made like a video every day of his quarantine, and he was like he was not happy. I guess I don't want to go into it too much because I don't want to like give out to him, but like he wasn't happy with the food, he wasn't happy with his room. He really really wanted a window like that opened. He was so not happy about that. Which is fair enough, like everyone's different. They just, I guess the hotel are just doing the best they can with the rooms they have, and everything like that. And yeah, he said like he just wasn't happy with like the treatment that he got. So that was like interesting that someone can have such a different experience, but I suppose like, yeah, everyone's different. But yeah, that was kind of entertaining because like he kept like commenting like things in the group, and like I think like no one else was like really agreeing with him, and it was like a little bit of a row. It's like some drama. So that's kind of entertaining. And what else? What else did they do? Oh, they also put on like a fitness video every morning, either fitness or yoga or like something that you can follow along, which is like really cool. And yeah, like loads of people just like put in like pictures of what they're doing. Like some people are doing art and stuff. And yeah, that is it. Also, yes, people were putting in a picture of like their view out the window. And when I arrived, I was like, in hindsight, this is so funny, but like, I was like, oh, I don't have a view like onto the road. I was like disappointed with my view. Like I was disappointed with this view, because it just faces out onto apartments, and like, I can't like see anyone. I couldn't like, you know, watch people go by or whatever, which would be kind of like entertaining. But then I saw some people's views, and like, just here is like a parking lot, and I like see over the parking lot, so like I see like all the sky and everything. But some people actually like the parking lot is their view, like the people like three or four floors below me, they can just see into the parking lot, and like they have to keep their blinds closed most of the time and stuff because like there'll be people in there. I'm like, that is miserable. Like they have no sky, they can't see the sky, and I thought that was kind of miserable. So it made me appreciate my view. Could always be worse. So yes, I'm gonna eat this and some of this, and I might get food later. Like, what is it now? It's like 12:30 now, and dinner is like 6:30. Like, it is kind of a long gap. So I have been getting some snacks. Sometimes I get McDonald's chips and milkshake, which is so bad now, but like, kind of like treat yourself while I can. And yeah, and I'm doing a workout today, so I can definitely justify getting whatever I want. So yeah, that is the crack. Hope you enjoy my little, oh, this is like a mukbang. Cool. So yeah, I will see you. I don't know what I'm gonna do after this. I might do some, I'll probably do some study and then a workout. I should probably do those things. So I'm gonna do those, and then I'm gonna probably order a McDonald's because now I've said it and I really want it. I'm just addicted to the chips and the milkshake. Like, I don't really like the veggie burger, so I can't get really, I don't really get anything else. But just that is so good. Anyway, rant over. I'll talk to you later. So, you know, I've been working hard doing some study. Yes, some anatomy study, and I thought, you know, I'm gonna treat myself. I did eat quite a bit of that lunch, I must admit, but I may have done a little something something. I just got chips and a milkshake. It's just my favorite thing from McDonald's. I love it so much, so I'm gonna eat that and do some study and be somewhat productive, and yeah. So I got my letter from the hotel saying that, congratulations, you are so close to completing your 2 weeks with us. So exciting. So yeah, they told me that I can't check out between 8 a.m. and 10:30, which is a little bit unfortunate because that was when I was going to check out. So I'm gonna have to check out before 8. I'm gonna try and check out for like 7:30 or something. Because after 10:30 would be a bit too late for me. My plan is to rent a car. I'm going to rent a car and drive to Bendigo. It's about 7 hours. I'm so excited. I cannot wait to just get out. And I can see loads of Australia. I can take my time. Like, it'll be really nice and chilled. I really didn't want to fly because I'd have to fly into Melbourne, which is under like stage 4 lockdown. And you're really not meant to be leaving Melbourne. Yeah, I just really didn't want to fly into an area with like such strict regulations, because although I will have a letter telling, like, saying that I can travel out of Melbourne, I just, it'll be a lot of hassle, and I'm not even sure like what the story with public transport is or anything. So this means I can just drive straight to Bendigo. I don't have to fly to Melbourne and get a train like up. So that's the plan. I cannot wait. I actually am just so excited. So yeah, I'm going to organize, book my car. Hopefully, yeah, I think I can pick it up at like 8, so I'll leave here at around 7:30, get there for around 8 and pick up the car. I'll get like an Uber over. I think it's really close by actually. And then yeah, off I go. Okay, so I'm gonna book that now, and yeah, update you when I'm all organized. It feels like I'm getting out of here. I've just got my car from Hertz. It was really expensive because I have to, because I'm dropping it off in a different place than I'm picking up the car. Obviously I'm picking it up in Adelaide, I'm dropping it off in Bendigo. So like, adds so much onto it, so much cheaper if you bring it back to where you got it, but unfortunately I'm not. But whatever, it still probably worked out, but the same as getting a flight and a train and then transport to the airport and stuff. So it's not too bad. And I booked my checkout time for 7:30. I pick up the car at 8. It takes 20 minutes to get there in an Uber, so that should be perfect timing. So excited, guys. I'm so excited. Yeah. Now, what am I going to do? Now I'm too hyped to do anything. I think I'm just going to... It's now 2 o'clock. I have until 6. Then I have dinner. See how, like... Today there's not a whole lot to do. But I've just kind of like been chilling out, to be honest, because I'm gonna be working like super hard when I get to Bendigo, and I'll definitely be wishing I was back here chilling out all day within a few weeks, I think. So I'm gonna try and make the most of it and chill out as much as possible. And like, I am so pumped to start working. I cannot wait to get there. I just want them to give me like all the jobs. I've like never been in such a good like headspace to like start a job, because I just so want to do something. I've never driven an automatic car before. Isn't that weird? All my cars have been manual, but I feel like it's a lot easier to go from manual to automatic than never have driven a manual car before. So should be fine, should be fun and easy. It's actually a pretty straight road once I get out of Adelaide. Like, it's pretty basic to get there. The only problem is that I don't have like Wi-Fi or like the internet on my phone, because I don't have an Australian SIM card. So yeah, it would be like super expensive if I had to use my roaming. So I'm going to save. I think I can save the, I think I can save the directions onto my phone with Google Maps, so I can use them offline. I'm like 99% sure I can do that. Maybe that's my next thing I'm gonna do, actually. So I'll do that, and then I'll just have that. It'll be grand. And I'll also have my laptop if my phone dies to charge it. See, I've thought of everything, guys. I've so much time to think, so I've thought of everything. Anyway, I'm gonna save that journey and the directions now. And then maybe do more Sudoku. I'm feeling inspired. I feel like I could get another number. I got one number. I don't know if I said that in all that morning. One number, how bad is it? So yeah, I'm feeling like I can get another number. Can do it. Hey guys. If I ordered a pizza for dinner, would you promise not to tell anyone that I did this? Just be between us, right? You won't like tell anyone. Is that bad? I think it's because it's my like second last night, so I'm feeling like treat yourself. And I've heard that we get like a really nice dinner tomorrow night, so I kind of already want a pizza. I haven't had a pizza in like weeks. This is such a bad video. I'm really sorry, guys. Basically, I did nothing today. I didn't even do the workout. Although there is still time. I really don't want to. It's just so hard to be motivated in here. Like, the first week, I was like on the ball. I worked out like every day and I was so good. But like, it's just very repetitive. and it's hard to like, yeah, it's hard to get the motivation to do really anything in here. But yeah, I knew, like, I did the important things, like the Sudoku, Sudoku even, and also study. I did actually study, so that is kind of the most important thing. And I think I just deserve a pizza. And I also saw that Domino's delivers, and I haven't had a Domino's pizza in so long. I'm gonna do it. Please don't judge me in this video, guys. Also, I'm sorry, it's kind of like probably a bit boring, this video, but there's really nothing to show you. I've showed you kind of everything that goes on. Instead of calling me, the nurse actually came to the door to check on me, because it's like my second last day. So that was fun. Yeah. I couldn't download my trip, but I could download the map. That doesn't make sense. But anyway, I downloaded the Google Map thing, so I will be able to drive there. I'll be all good. So yeah, that's gonna happen in 2 days. It's so exciting. So yeah, I think that's it for now. I think I'm gonna get a pizza. I think I might get it kind of soon. It's like 5 o'clock at the moment. Dinner usually comes around 6 or half 6. Also, I used to like ring, well, not used to, well, once I was going to order dinner and I rang and asked them not to send up my dinner just so it didn't get like wasted. They just ended up anyway. So now I've given up. I just like let them send it up, because they just seem to send it up regardless. So yeah, it comes with a brownie though, so I'm going to eat that. But it's like a bean and something patties. I think they're like veggie burgers, but without the Bundy part. I'm just like, I'm not feeling all these vegetables. I've never eaten so many vegetables in my life. I'm like the worst vegetarian ever. So yes, I'm gonna order a pizza now, and I will update you when it arrives.
because I think I just should treat myself. Yep,
I agree, thank you. Okay, see you later. Okay, so quick update, I have my pizza. Yes, I ordered it, and I'm watching some show jumping. And this just could be like the best night ever, you know? I'm sitting in, got some pizza, good show jumping, I'm about to call some of my friends, catch up with them. So yeah, living my best life, guys. What else happened? I called my parents. They call me like every night, so we just catch up. All the horses and dogs and everything are good. So yeah, it's all good. Can't wait to eat this pizza. I'm so excited. Hey guys, so I have a pizza. I chilled out, talked to some of my friends. Well, I only talked to one of them because time zones. They were only like getting up. I was actually halfway through filming that like little clip and my friend rang me. So I think she heard me talking about her and she was like, hold up, less of that. So yes, I'm gonna end the vlog here because it's currently 8:30. I am going to have a shower and go to bed. And none of you want to see that. So I hope this wasn't like completely boring. I feel like because it was in the same room every day, because it, like every clip was in basically the same location, it felt really, really repetitive. So I hope it wasn't like super boring. But yeah, I hope you kind of enjoyed it and I will see you next time. I'll be hopefully in my new job in Bendigo when you see this. Fingers crossed that I don't randomly get like a positive COVID test result or something crazy happens that stops me getting there. I don't know. Fingers crossed for me, guys. So yeah, I will see you next time. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And yeah, see ya.